How are you?
I'm fine, it's a video, I just made a TikTok for myself.
We're gonna win for once. I have four fights. This is I
can't stand you. This is where Forrester. Jamie Forrester. Jamie Forrester. And now we're barely
breathing. Because we won, we beat Shrewsbury away at the new ground and we humbled them.
Very excited. Wow, it's an experience coming with you.
Even though it's half time.
We've got half the rubber on the roundabout, but we nearly rear-ended somebody on the M1. But
cake or death?
Cake or death?
Yeah, cake or death?
Death.
Hey, they don't call him Iffy for no reason.
Iffy on your own. Yeah, on your butt.
From the dismal to the average. Crap, my God.
Hello, it's roughly 43 minutes past 8 on Saturday the 7th of May, and Lincoln City have been a non-league club for just shy of 4 hours now. I didn't do a video for all the short minutes because I couldn't be bothered, and we ended up getting relegated anyway, and other than a brief moment where someone lied about Port Vale being ahead, it's not ahead, has scored rather, there was nothing really celebratory in the video, so yeah. I'm not sure whether this leaves the videos or anything like that. I really don't know. I mean, don't get me wrong, I've not been to most of the conference grounds. I've not been to Braintree, not been to Alverton, not been to, what else is coming up, Farnborough, Woking, some Liver teams that are in the playoffs at the moment, so there will be a lot of new places that will be going, which I haven't been to, which I'm quite pleased about in a way, because it'd be nice. It's nice to get to some other places for a change, but I don't know if the videos will be continuing, because I don't get that many views on the videos anyway, and that's why we're in the region above, and we're playing in front of crowds of more than 400-500, which will be the crowd when we go down to places like Hazy Yenning. It seems almost surreal going down, almost to the point where you start wondering where we're won, and then I just think we've been crap all season. I think a few months ago I was talking about the bloody playoffs. But then again, who'd have seen that run coming that we went on, like, off the top of my head, I think it was 10 games, 8 defeats or something stupid like that. I mean, you can't do that and expect to stay up, really. So yeah. Well, it's been 3 or 4 months since that day at Aldershot, and safe to say that Tinsbank has not been a generally happy place since, so much to the point where that right behind me is one of the most depressing things I've ever seen. And interesting definition they have of the word proud. Yeah, because I'm sure every team that comes down from League Two is absolutely thrilled to be in the Blue Square Premier Division. And proud members. I'll tell you what, if we do actually get promoted at any point back to the Football League, first thing I'm doing is coming down to Centre Bank and tearing that sign down. That's how disgusting that sign is. Anyway, so it's been a summer of change at Centre Bank. It's been a case of a lot of new players, and a load of the wasters from last season are now gone, thank God. Because quite frankly, some of them are the biggest waste of spaces I've ever seen. I'm not just talking about as footballers, I'm talking about as human beings. When you can't even be bothered to try, when you earn that much amount of money a week, is fucking ridiculous. Pardon my French. So yeah, now we've got in players that I'm actually quite impressed with so far. They all appear to care. And some of them may not be the best, but at least they care for once. So yeah, things are looking different at Centre Bank. I don't know what to expect of the season, to be honest. I'm thinking it'll be a struggle. I'm not denying that. Anyone who comes down thinking they're going to walk the league is what's my favourite phrase from the past?
I'm going to try and stay calm. You shit, Jackson! You went to a team who've only won 4 games all season and they beat us 5-1. We're not. I mean, we were 10 points before kick-off off the playoffs. We're probably third right now, I don't know the result.
What
the
shit?
No, sorry. No, I've had enough. Anyone who clearly thinks that we're still going to make the playoffs, you're deluded. You're deluded. 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 Deluded.
Ah, oh, yes, deluded. I think the last team to come straight back up were Carlisle back in 2005-06, and even they only finished in the playoffs. In fact, I can't remember the last side that went down and came back up as champions, even a few years later. It always seems to be a new side every single year. The playoff side is occasionally an ex-league side. I mean, you had Oxford, Torquay, so on and so forth, but in general. I think... Sorry about that. I'd be delighted with high mid-table, top 10 definitely. Anything high is obviously a bonus, but I'd be happy just to win a few games for once. Or at least see players that give a shit, which will definitely be a change. We haven't had that for quite some time. So here he is, my good friend Mr. Calvert.
Hello!
Me and Mr. Calvert first met in 2002 when I stomped on his pilot talkie because it had a fly.
I still don't remember that.
Just me, it happened.
Yeah, fair enough.
So how do you think pre-season's gone, Mr. Calvert?
I've been impressed with what I've seen so far. I think that Steve Tilson's managed to build a young, hard-working team of players. So I'm hoping...
Change from last season.
I'm hoping for a decent season.
Happy days, excellent. How do you think we'll do today?
Don't know, really. I don't want to get too overexcited, but... I don't know anything about Southport. I don't know what players they've got, so I don't know.
To be honest, I've never heard of any of them.
No, I haven't. So I'd like to obviously start off with a win, but...
Excellent. I'll give you the high five in a moment. Anyway, how do you feel we'll do today?
I've got a bad feeling today. Just because we could be welcomed into the conference and what with maybe some dirty tactics or... few nasty tackles, so
how dare you stereotype the conference?
I'm going to say either 0-0. In fact, no, I'm just going to say 0-0.
Wow. You're thrilling, man, Mr. Heath. Well, what can you say? It's we didn't feel lonely before, we definitely do now. Sally, what do you think? It's depressing, this, really, isn't it? Well. Only 45 games and 85 minutes to go. Oh, here comes the afro. Oh, fun.
He's got a shot.
As well. Great goal.
Oh well, points better than nothing, obviously, and it's more than we had at the stage last season. To be fair, I didn't think we played overly well. We took our goals well, but we didn't play overly well. But I'd say a draw was a fair result. So. How are you?
I'm pleased we didn't lose.
Excellent, makes a change, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. I can't remember the last time I saw him pick up anything away from home.
Excellent, fair enough. How do you think we played?
Not too bad at times. At times we looked alright sometimes going forward, but I think we looked a bit dodgy at the back.
Excellent, so no changes there.
No changes there.
Excellent, cool, thank you.
Thank you.